Hey there, mathematicians, or maybe I should say howdy, partner. I hope you brought your lasso for this one, because we got a bucking bronco of a problem to solve. There's 18 horses and 27 cows in this pasture, and it's time to round them up and bring them back to the ranch. The cows and horses need to go in different pens, and each pen needs to have the same number of animals. Corralling these critters ain't easy, and there's a limited number of pens back at the ranch, so we better make sure we put the greatest number possible in each pen. Can you help me figure out how many pens we need and how many animals should go in each one? In the last lesson, we learned about prime and composite numbers. I noticed that 18 and 27 are both composite, which means they have more than two factors. Remember, factors are numbers that multiply together to result in another number. Do you have any ideas about how their factors could help us figure this out? Pause the video here while you brainstorm ideas and jot down your thoughts. You always have the best ideas, but just to be sure, we'll take a closer look at factors before we jump into solving. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to identify factors of a given number and identify the greatest common factor of a set of numbers. This sounds like just what we need to get these ranch animals wrangled. Yee-haw! Speaking of factors, let's review how to find all of the factors of a number. Let's use 18. We'll start by listing all the pairs of numbers that we can multiply to get 18. 1 times 18 and 2 times 9 are factor pairs. Are there any others? If you aren't sure if a number is a factor of another number, you can always try dividing. If you get a whole number, you found another pair of factors. Let's try this with 3. 18 divided by 3 is 6, a whole number, which means another factor pair. What about 4? 18 divided by 4 is 4.5. That's not a whole number, so 4 is not a factor of 18. We found all the number pairs that can multiply to equal 18. So we found all of 18's factors. Now it's your turn. Can you find all the factors of 27? Pause the video here while you list them in your guided notes. The factors of 27 are 1, 3, 9, and 27. Let's investigate how this information can help us corral those critters. 18's factors are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, and 18, while 27's factors are 1, 3, 9, and 27. Like I mentioned before, 18 and 27 share some of the same factors. Which ones do they have in common? Interesting. They both share the factors 1, 3, and 9. These are examples of common factors. A common factor is a factor that two or more numbers share. We need to put as many animals as possible in each pen, so what we really need is their greatest common factor. Greatest common factor, or GCF for short, is the largest of the common factors. If the common factors of 18 and 27 are 1, 3, and 9, then the greatest common factor is 9. 9 is the largest number that can divide into both 18 and 27. This means we can have all the animals corralled into equal groups of 9 in each pen. If we need 9 animals in each pen, can you figure out how many cow pens and how many horse pens we'll end up with? Pause here and solve in your guided notes. 18 horses divided by 9 per pen is 2 horse pens, and 27 cows divided by 9 per pen is 3 cow pens. We're ready to wrangle. Oh, Nelly, word got out that we did a great job corralling our horses and cows, so we've been asked to help out with another ranch down the road. This ranch has 48 horses and 84 cows roaming around. These numbers are big, so it may take a while to make sure we don't miss any factors. I wonder if there's a faster way. What else have we learned about factors? I can't believe I almost forgot. We can use prime factorization. You may remember from the last lesson that prime factorization is the list of prime numbers that, when multiplied together, results in the original number. Prime factorization breaks down a number until it cannot be factored anymore. This prevents us from missing any factors when comparing numbers. We can use a factor tree to find the prime factors of a number. Pause here to complete the factor trees to find the prime factorization of 48 and 84 in your guided notes. Here are my factor trees. I found the prime factorization of 48 to be 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. And the prime factorization of 84 is 2 times 2 times 3 times 7. To determine the greatest common factor of 48 and 84, we need to compare their prime factorizations. 48 and 84's prime factorizations have a 2, another 2, and a 3 in common. Because prime factorization is a breakdown of a number into its fundamental building blocks, we can compare those building blocks to find which ones they have in common. When we multiply all the prime factors they have in common, we're actually finding the largest shared piece of these numbers, also known as their greatest common factor. 2 times 2 is 4, and 4 times 3 equals 12. So the GCF of 48 and 84 is 12. We could put 12 animals in each pen. Nice work, partner. Finding the GCF of a set of numbers is a helpful skill, not only out on the ranch, but also when simplifying fractions and working with ratios. Two things we'll be doing a lot of in this course. Let's do a practice problem just to make sure we've got it down. Using prime factorization, find the greatest common factor of 24 and 32. Pause here and we'll check your work when you're done. Based on these factor trees, the prime factorization of 24 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. And the prime factorization of 32 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. If we compare each of these, we find that they have 2 times 2 times 2 in common. 2 times 2 is 4, and 4 times 2 equals 8. The greatest common factor of 24 and 32 is 8. Awesome job! Not only did we prove ourselves worthy to be ranch hands, we also learned that we can identify all the factors of a number by listing factor pairs. The greatest common factor is the largest shared factor within a set of numbers, and the GCF can be found using prime factorization too. Great work today, mathematicians! Hold your horses, you can't go yet. We figured out that we would need 12 animals in each pen, but we still have to let the other farmer know how many horse pens and cow pens they need. There's 48 horses and 84 cows. Can you help me solve this? Pause here to crunch the numbers. Let's see, 48 horses divided by 12 per pen is 4 horse pens. 84 cows divided by 12 per pen is 7 cow pens. Well, buckaroos, we did it. Don't forget to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go along with this lesson so you can keep crunching those numbers. So long, partner.